Welcome back to CC Rock. I'm still Metal Matt, and you know, that was an amazing show we just saw with Dream Theater. And usually we don't do interviews after the show, but this is a special occasion. We've got James LaBrie, vocalist for Dream Theater. I'm fired up. I'm happy. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. My wife's going to kill me.
Your wife's going to kill me. Well, at least you have somebody close by that you can go home to. You know, mine's like 3,500 miles away, so.
So tell me, what happened today? Lucky. Where were you? You had a little joyride.
Crying into my... Well, actually, the day, it's been a very long day, but it's been a great day. Myself and Mike and Jordan.
Mike Varney from Travel Records.
No. Mike Portnoy, Mike, myself, Jordan Rudess, and we all were invited by some fans of ours that actually work at the Skywalker Ranch to go out and have a personal tour of the place and check it out and have lunch there. So that was really cool. Never been out there. It was quite amazing. Incredible, you know, all the people that work there and just the whole surrounding is just unbelievable. I'm sure a lot of people from this area have gone there.
Oh, yeah. I've never been there.
Really?
No.
Oh, wow.
I spend my time at rock shows.
You have to do it. Yeah, same here. So, and then later in the day, I hooked up with Mike Varney from Magna Carta and Shrapnel. And we were, you know, just hanging out, driving around, checking out the scenery, and we ran out of gas on the way back here. Mm-hmm. So I was on the side of a highway for about an hour and a half for AAA to come and rescue us and give us some gas so that we could at least get to a gas station. And then we finally made it. But we were on the other side of the Golden Gate coming into San Fran.
Up in Sausalito area.
Yeah, exactly.
Beautiful zone. Beautiful.
It's actually
You know, back in February, I was in Costa Rica, and I missed your show in February here, but one day, I tried to get back early, but you know, those beaches in Costa Rica were pretty cool.
I wasn't roughing it, all right?
But, like I said, your set list from that show, you played the whole Scenes from a Memory.
Right, correct.
This one, totally different set list. Amazing. I mean, yes. And they're both great shows, but this set list was definitely cool because you guys just grabbed things left and right out of the book.
Actually, we've been getting that sort of feedback. Since we started this leg for the U.S. tour, a lot of people obviously by email, you're completely in touch with your fans. And the response to this set, a lot of people have said the same thing. They just love it because it's going, you know, back and forth, present and past. And we're touching almost on every album except the first one. But every other album, we're playing songs from it. So, it's great. It's 2.5 hours, you know.
Amazing.
So it's a long set. And but the fans are getting their money's worth.
Thank you.
memory. Mm-hmm. I mean, it deals with resurrection. It's a very different subject. I mean, like I said,
yeah, reincarnation,
conceptual album,
yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. resurrection. I must be thinking about Rob Halford too much. Two great vocalists. Yeah
that's but, amazing. That
reincarnation.
Guy's...
Oh yeah. Well, you guys are both, you know, amazing vocalists. God, what do you think about Rob Halford?
I mean, he's incredible. What is he? Is he 49 now?
Yeah,
he's singing like a freaking 18-year-old.
Oh yeah.
I mean, it's incredible. I mean, I've always loved him as a vocalist. I've just thought he's. You know, incredibly, like, he's so unique, so distinct. I don't think there's any other vocalists out there like him. Yeah. And I mean, my favorites, you know, he's in the list, but I mean, you know, Freddie Mercury was a big inspiration to me, Steve Perry, Lou Gramm, Nat King Cole, you know, and Rob Halford, and you know, and then you have Bruce Dickinson, all. I mean, they're all great singers. There's just something about Rob, like, Rob is just, there's really no other singer like him. I mean, he's singing in the stratosphere, and he's doing it. You know, he's doing it no problem, and it's just his real signature. He's always been capable of doing it, and he still amazes
he's
me.
He's the metal god.
Yeah, he really is.
Of all the singers out there.
Absolutely.
You guys say, wow, this guy's amazing.
I think there's another vocalist out there, not to get on the whole vocalist thing, but a lot of people don't realize, even someone like Steven Tyler, who I think is just an incredible rock singer. I think that if, you know, you went back to the earlier Aerosmith album, like Get Your Wings and Rocks and Toys in the Attic and all that stuff. I mean, it's just incredible how he's singing. And even the later stuff when they, you know, got their second round.
Yeah.
It's incredible what he's doing on those albums as well. So like I said, he's another great singer.
There's a lot of great albums out there, and you think of conceptual albums. Mm-hmm. Scenes from a Memory is a conceptual album, but you know, I always think of The Wall, Mind Crime,
absolutely.
Tommy. But you know, yours was a very strong. Uh-huh. I mean, Scenes from a Memory. How did you pick a conceptual album as being what you wanted to do?
Well, I think that after the last album, Falling Into Infinity, we really knew once we had finished that tour that we wanted to, I guess, get back to Dream Theater's roots. Mm-hmm. So getting back to a more progressive approach, we had been speaking of doing a concept album for since the beginning of the band, just waiting for the right opportunity to show itself. So we knew that at this point in our careers that this was the time, and the label was behind it 100%. They gave us free rein. I mean, you know, we went into the studio on our own, wrote, produced the album. They didn't bother us, which was incredible. A big leap of faith on their part. And we just knew that this was what we wanted to give to our fans, and we knew that this would be an incredible challenge for us, but we were up for it because it was just something that made sense at this point in our
careers. Well, it definitely stands up there in the categories of The Wall and Tommy and Mind Crime. When you talk about Mind Crime.
We're talking about, you know, albums you just mentioned are just incredible.
Oh, they are. I think you guys fall. I mean, like I said, there's all these different eras of time when things happen, I think. Mm-hmm. And The Wall was a very special era.
Oh, that's my favorite of all of them. But I mean,
I still think Roger Waters is pink. So anyhow.
Thank you.
You look at Spock's beard, which is your opening act.
Excellent.
Which
band.
I thought, yeah, I think the guy, the vocalist, was pretty amazing.
Oh, Neil's great.
He reminds me almost
Neil
of
Neil writes
of,
all the stuff, and you know, yeah, he's
yeah,
mix incredible.
Of Marillion and Billy Joel or something. I don't know. It's like,
well, I think Gentle Giant and Genesis.
Yeah.
And, yeah. I mean, and then there's the more of the contemporaries that comes out in them, because they also, as progressive as they are, there's a sort of a, for lack of a better term, there is the more accessible, mm-hmm. in it, or, you know, I was going to say pop, but I wouldn't want to go that far, but yeah, they are, they're an incredible band, excellent band, and we respect them a lot. Yeah, well, it's a lot of fun touring with them, too.
There's rumors about a DVD video coming out soon.
Yes.
Well, what is it?
Actually, we're on the 30th will be our last show, mm-hmm. in the U.S., and we're playing at the Roseland in New York, mm-hmm. and yes, we are. We're filming. It'll be a multi-film shoot for a DVD release. As for when the release is going to be, I can't tell you at this point. But I mean, you know, obviously we'll go right into post-production.
Basically.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. We're going to do all of Scenes from a Memory, uh-huh. and then so that'll be about an hour and a half. We're going to take a 15-minute intermission, come back, and do a set similar to this, touching upon a lot of our other songs. And so it's going to be very cool. We're really excited about doing that show. And then I guess at some point down the future, in the future, it will be released. Mm-hmm. But
you guys put a lot of your own time and effort into these videos. I mean, you guys have done lots of videos over the years.
Yeah, I mean,
are these things produced somewhere else, and all of a sudden here it is?
I mean, as far as home videos, and that Mike gets extremely involved, mm-hmm. in that, just because that's the way, you know, he's very in control of things, and he likes to be that in that position. So yeah, a lot has to, he does oversee everything. I mean, we might have discussions of what we want, mm-hmm. incorporated within these home videos and so on. So he takes that to the plate, and it usually gets done. But yeah, he's more the overseer with things like that.
Are you working on any new material right now, or what's up? Are you guys like, kind of just thinking about the video right now?
And yeah, myself, I mean, I'm writing right now and plan on going in to record my next solo project,
solo
which
project.
Is Mall Muzzler. I already have one
is
out
this,
there.
Is this a Barney thing?
Yeah, this is for Magna Carta.
Oh, cool.
And I already have one out, Mall Muzzler, and now I'm doing the second one. Mm-hmm. And so I'll be recording November, December, January, and then hopefully that'll be a February release. As far as Dream Theater, you know, we're not going to be done touring until the end of October, mm-hmm. in Europe.
Right.
And we will have been out over a year at that point.
Quite a haul.
So, yeah, you know, at the end of October, we're going to take a break as far as Dream Theater goes for a couple months, and then regroup and start getting right into the next album, which I would think mid-January, late January, that would start. And should be very exciting, and we're already starting to speak about it, you know, where we want to go with it. And I think the fans will be happy.
Well, I was going to say, you guys have definitely treated your fans nice tonight. And
mm-hmm.
like I said, the last few times I've seen you guys, amazing. Thank you very much, James.
Great. Thank you.
Beautiful. Weekend vacation. I got some non-alcoholic beer. That's why my stomach's been so trim this trip. Anyhow, I hope you enjoy Dream Theater. Great band. I'll tell you, a very nice guy, James LaBrie. Next month, we're going to have a great show with April Wine. So definitely, this will be a great show. April Wine all the way from Canada. We brought them to the Walnut Festival. But enough about that. I'm at Tabacon Resort in Costa Rica. Hot mineral springs. Killer place. If you ever get to Costa Rica, definitely check out Tabacon. But if you want to get in touch with me, Metal Matt at CC Rock, give me a phone call at 925-933-6264. You can also email me, metalmatt@home.com. We'll see you next time. Buena vida.
Yeah.